Morning, 8 o'clock. Nice frosty morning. Have a look at this. It's going to be a nice day, isn't it? Yeah. Way out in the middle this morning. Fucking driving down the motorway, or down the little carriageway, and bloody mirror fell off. Couldn't stop it. As I looked in the little mirror, someone drove over it anyway. There you go. Fucking sort that out later. Right, what we got here? Been in the baker's. Pasty, ham roll, cheese roll, salad, and the bestest jam donuts in the world. If anyone's in the Broxbourne area, aren't you? Broxbourne High Street, the baker's there, what's it called? The bread bin. Yeah, best donuts in the world. Alright, let's see what's going on. Can't see a labourer here this morning. What's happened there? Grab that. Got some sausages for the boys. Right. Let's walk up here. As you can see, we're all covered up. Sand's all covered up. That was all covered up last night. That should be. Two packs of bricks left. We're loaded out. Two thirds. And we've still got this front to do. And the gable. So there ain't enough, I'll tell you that now. And that was the perils of doing this patio. But they said they can get them, so we'll see. Morning! Heater's on. Morning.
Morning.
Morning, everyone's here. Right, here, I'll grab that electric thing. Some donuts. Sausages, I cooked them last night. Well, from it. There's a bit of black pudding there and all. Just chucking the microwave if you need. I don't want no more of them. You alright, mate?
Yeah, you alright?
That mixer ain't going round.
No.
Oh.
Too cold.
Fucking thick on my windscreen this morning.
Yeah. Really was.
Yeah. Oh yeah, let's have a look at this. Yeah, it's white, isn't it? Oh, we ain't going to start for a while. Any excuse for this fucking lot? I don't care. Right. A few weeks ago, I was going to do just a talk on profiles and building corners and that, and then it sort of kicked off, didn't it, between a couple of YouTubers. So I didn't do it because I didn't want to be looked, seen, deemed to be jumping on the bandwagon because it ain't me, ain't what I do. Yeah, if I get time lunchtime, I'll talk through it with you. My thoughts on it all anyway, because I've got plenty of experience on it. Yeah, we'll do that later. I don't really watch other channels. I've got them. I'm aware what goes on. I don't really want to sit, get home and watch people fucking laying bricks, but what I do, I generally just go through the comments, and that gives me an idea what's gone on, and if there is anything gone on, if anyone's fallen off the scaffold or anything. So if there's anything I think I might want to look at, I'll just have a quick look through. But yeah, so I do know what goes on. All right then, I think we'll have a cup of tea, think about it. Speak to you in a while. These are good, and warmers. You just activate them up, and stick them in your pocket, keep your hands warm. They're good till about 12 o'clock, and they've sort of worked all day. That's what I meant to say earlier. That video I put up yesterday, the camera angle's just that little bit wrong. I did have it right, because I got it on a hat. I think I walked into the scaffold, hit the camera on the scaffold, and it knocked it out of bonk. So I'm going to, just while we're finishing this wall off, there's a little bit I want to do about working above your head, which we are doing here. You know, it's only for the young lads, apprentices and that. So I'll do that, but it won't be long. That was too long yesterday, I think. I'm going to stop doing these long videos like that. Okay. For those questioning my bonding, that's the difference. That's just two bricks I've randomly picked up. I didn't even look for them. You know, I explained all this before. You know, you lay two or three small ones and then lay a big one. Two of them small ones, you're going to get back to a third bond, quarter bond.
But you put one more big one in and you're back to half bond. That's exactly how it is.
Oh, too cold to start. No, I'm going to put some probe holes up, they've got to go up. Alright. Lakes. We've got scaffold problems out in, so we're going to cut a board. Alright. Squared off best we can. It's good. Scaffolders have made it hard for us as usual. What's he on about? Huh?
I said, did you need a ball cut that in?
No, no, we're all right here, mate. Sorry, I just didn't hear you. It's down here, so, oh, yeah. Oh, fucking hit the epoxy probe on it. Right, that's the best we're going to get there. It's in. Check that square. That's a little bit out. That'll do. Oops, that's near enough. I've got to go in a little bit. So fucking awkward with these scaffold boards. Take a minute to check that when we get to it. It's got to go in. Push it in. Do that a bit. A bit more. Just a touch. And we'll check that again before we start. One profile, one corner built. Oh dear. What's going on? What am I missed out on?
Make these boats safe here.
Oh yeah, they're moving, aren't they? Yeah.
Can I have one, Dave?
Down like that. Fuck you know. Lost something, there it is. Right. A little bit more room here, not a lot. Normally get that in there to hold it, but I can't because everything's in the way. So we will persevere. It can be done. That will probably go round enough time I whack the other one in. The idea of the wedge is that they tend to fall out when you're messing about a bit, but it's actually sitting on this padlock, so it's not going to fall out, so happy days. Happy days. Yeah, like that. I'll do that touch. Do it. One corner built. If I hit anything with this camera again. Right, that's square. That's plumb, maybe out of touch. Again, we'll check these before we start. That's good. And that's got to come out. I don't like that when it has to happen. It's fucking awkward now. The only problem with these. Someone's going to have to go down here, or will I go down here? I don't care. I can't get to the screw to adjust it. It's quite warm now, the sun's out. Right, yeah.
Where are you, mate?
There, yeah, this one.
Yeah.
Just undo it a touch. Twat them more. Just need a touch. That's it.
About the other way.
I think it's all right the other way. I'll just check. That's good. That's it. We've just put a post up there, and I just to pull off.
Yeah.
I'll put one of my long clamps on there, just one. So that's enough. Do that later, can't we? We're finished. I'll get the clamp out now. There's some small bricks there,
yeah.
Somewhere. I think they're the ones on the floor. That little red one there.
Some here.
That red one right at the back is a tiny one.
What?
That
oh,
one.
Here.
Yeah.
That is tiny.
Yeah, but that's good. Yeah, we've got a. We're tight through that front. Oh, we're tight fucking everywhere. What have we got here? Lintels. Lintels are turned up. What's that on the back there? That back pallet? That's not ours, is it?
No.
Is
that
not?
Yeah. Oh, these
right here? Yeah. There you go, lintels. Right, lying above your head. This is more for young apprentice bricklayers. If you can avoid lying above your head, don't fucking do it. I don't know how we've ended up doing it here with this scaffold. I'm not quite sure what happened, but we are. These tyres down. Right, what happens is, get a bit down. Two things happen when you're lying above your head. One is, you lay the brick towards you. It's a natural thing, it can't be helped. Well, it can be helped, but if you don't address it, that's what happens. And for some reason, I don't know why, it happens to me, if you don't watch it, I always get forward. Well, I don't anymore, so keep an eye on it. And I suppose because you're up there, you're not just pulling that brick back as much as you should. Now what I'll do, what happens is, the gusher up here, people tend to do that, and that brick is tilted, can you see that? And the other thing what happens is it pushes the line out. And what happens is if that one pushes that line out, and then the next brick pushes the line out, and you keep going like that, you end up with a line out there, and a belly in it, which is no good. So I consciously, yeah, belly like mine. Push the back down like that and knock it back. We're tight here anyway, I've got to do that. And then obviously, you check it with the level at the end of the job. You know, you get it where you want. Just give it a couple of taps on the back. So it ain't pulling forward and it ain't on that line. You know, even just keep it a little bit further back from the line than you normally would. That's a big fat one. There's another few more. Yeah, it's right up. Well, the small ones. A bit more muck than that. No, all small ones. Show you. Here's the level. Let's check it. Just make sure. See how that's flat there, not tipping. Flat there, not tipping. That's what you want.
Like and subscribe,
though, eh? Like and subscribe, yeah. Yeah, you're on YouTube.
I see, I was
like,
I thought
it
was a torture camera.
It's, what is it? Is it a torture or a camera? I don't know. No, it's a camera. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
You said bricklayers worldwide. Go to that.
On YouTube. Yeah, it won't be on there till tomorrow. I'll do it tonight.
Loads of stuff on there. That will build
yeah. Yeah, have a look tomorrow.
Yeah, will be, mate. Put the wire around. I want to write it down before I forget it.
Yeah. Right.
Sure, you should have changed that to black and white.
We should have done, shouldn't I? Yeah. I don't know how to do that. I can't do nothing, can I? I'm useless. Yeah.
Get
I thought you said you didn't want to be on it anymore.
Get Tom going like Fucking done it again. Poxy fucking thing.
What are you up to the weekend, mate?
Nothing.
Nothing?
Chilled one this weekend.
I'm out Sunday.
Oh, mechanic.
What's that about?
Suspension pump on the motor.
What, the new one?
Yeah.
Oh. Is that a warranty, though?
No, no, I knew that's what needed doing on it.
Oh, right. Fuck's sake. Topside scaffold. Look at that sooty, Sandy.
What are you
doing out there? Well, my mate wants to do a bit of shopping around Petticoat Lane. Yeah, I've got one here. And there's a food hall there. He reckons it's good. I'm going to do that. And then get on the piss. Draw it a day, see them marks, them blue ones, can you see that? I don't know how this camera's showing it. Liquid ink that. It's alright when it ain't wet. You just wipe it off with your tongue. Someone's put all these padlock clips along here and I keep tripping over them. Deaf ears. Fucking deaf ears. Let's see what we need. We need one of these. Rapido. Got a level there, mate. Hallelujah, that'll do ya. Let's get that full.
You want a sheet?
Oh yeah. What, you putting half of one there?
Yeah.
What was it?
It's just easier, isn't it? Otherwise you're just gonna fucking bulk out here.
Well, give me a full one, I'll cut it up here. If you can reach it.
Wait, that old shite into that is.
Yeah, it's just shit, isn't it? Yeah, this insulation's been a fucking nightmare. The first lot we got was really good. But now, it's expanding at nearly 170 mil. So the bit of time it takes to cut it, normally we set some boards up and cut a load, but we haven't. Cut it with that, am I?
Yeah. Yeah, got one. Yeah, I've got one here. Level up this. Done that yet? Good. Always plumb your reveals. Fucking, there's only a bee here.
Oh, it's lovely up here now, isn't it?
Beautiful. Oh, I've got everything here. I'll get a whole course of long ones, then I'll get a course of little ones, just to always mix them up.
So you want
to... They are, or they're not?
I don't
know. No, they're not. They mix up terrible.
They're not ready on any oven, is
it? No. What are you saying, Tom sucked it up?
Oh, I think they've been mixed up wrong.
You're not committing yourself in. Who might have done it?
Medium here, medium
small. Yeah. Alright. For those questioning my bonding, that's the difference. That's just two bricks I've randomly picked up, I didn't even look for them. And you know, I explained all this before. You know, you lay two or three small ones and then lay a big one. Two of them small ones, you're going to get back to a third bond, quarter bond. But you put one more big one in and you're back to half bond. That's exactly how it is. Ah, right. Provols. When I first started, I did mention this in a video last week, just as he was working. I started in the 70s, early 70s. And that time I just worked for two subbies before I ended up on the trail. One was house bashing and one was more commercial stuff. Now the guy, the subby who done the commercial stuff, he had Blake's profiles in them days because he knew that if he forked out for them, he's going to earn more money out of these blokes. Now, anyone says that you can build a corner just as quick as you can with profiles is just on a different planet, because that just isn't the case. The other guy I worked for was my mate. He was house bashing. Well, I used to work there in them days. We used to work 4 and 2 gang. I was the muck man. So I'd get there at 7:30, knock some muck up. Well, we'd both be there and we'd bang the corners out. 8 o'clock, the bricklayers would turn up, build the corners by 10, and that's how we'd work. And we earned money. We worked from 8 till sort of 4:30 in them days, 5 o'clock, basically, because the pubs never opened till 5. And that's where everyone wanted to be, but some never opened till 6, but no one worked that late. And yeah, that's how we worked. Now, the reason why, not the only reason, because they weren't as popular then, but why people didn't have profiles in them days, because most bricklayers never had vans. Builders had vans, but bricklayers never had vans. Now, you ain't going to get on a fucking double-decker bus with a set of Blake's profiles, are you? Because that's how, you know, some people got to work in the car. You can't get your profiles in the car unless you've got a roof rack, and then they're going to get nicked, aren't they? Bus or bike. So we just never had them, never used them, you know, and we worked fine and earned money. Now everyone's got vans, haven't they? Well, if you take the job seriously and you're doing your own work, you've got a van, haven't you? And your profiles go in them. Logistics, though. I worked in Holland in the 70s, the later 70s. That's all profiles there. Like, it's a different system there because, believe it or not, the carpenters set everything out. So you got a slab, the chippies turn up, they set it all out. They used timber profiles in them days. And the bricklayer just turns up, Dutch bricklayer turn up, a bucket of tools, 2 foot level, put the lines up, well, they set the level up, put a datum in, gauge marks, and just run it in. So they ain't got to carry profiles about, have they? The builder would get all that, their chippies would do all that. That's their system, that's how it used to be anyway. I don't like that word traditional. Traditional bricklaying, I don't get that, what that is. Everyone's using it, get traditional or profiles. If you went to Australia, traditional's profiles, because that's all they use, isn't it? And then again, the logistics are different. You go to Australia, you know, when I was out there in West Australia, building basically bungalows, really. I mean, you got, you know, high rise in the cities, but there's not a lot of brickwork on them. It's all curtain walling and what have you. And the bricklayer turn up in his truck, he can pull right next to the job. You got a slab there, polished concrete slab. Unload your profiles, prop them up on each corner, same thing, level round, gauge marks, and just lay bricks. Over here, if you're on a site, you know, I don't go on sites now, but what I've seen of it, your car park's about 1/2 mile away from the job. You've got to cart all your stuff over on the onto the site, you know, a big box of clamps and all that. Oh, no, I don't know how safe it is to leave that stuff over there overnight, I don't know. I don't think I would want to do that. You know, and you're carting them up and down because, you know, you're not doing single floors, it's, you know, you're building houses. So, I don't know. And that's the other thing, isn't it? You can't start work till 8 o'clock. We never started work till 8 o'clock. But I see some of these blokes, they're there at 7 o'clock apparently. I don't know what they're fucking doing. You know, maybe setting profiles up. But how long does it take to set a profile up? Get it at 8 o'clock, 10 miles to 8, set up, isn't it? So, you know, if I'm working for someone, I don't want to be there at 7 o'clock in the morning. I'll start work at 8. So, yeah. Profiles, I use them most of the time. But, you know, sometimes I can't be asked fucking getting them out and carting them on the job and that. If it's only a small job, I won't. Yeah, there was something else. I can't think what now. Profiles, yeah, that's it, really. Yeah, good. But don't always need them, do you? Right, I've got a... What have I got? I've got the jab. I've got my booster jab in about an hour, so I'm going to fuck off shortly. We're done here for the week. Right, have a nice weekend.